Tantor Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents Black History for Beginners by Denise Dennis, narrated by Janina Edwards. This is no time to engage in the luxury of cooling off or to take the tranquilizing drug of gradualism. Now is the time to make real the promises of democracy. Now is the time to make justice a reality for all of God's children. Martin Luther King, August 28, 1963. When Washington crossed the Delaware, two blacks were with him.
Black history?
That must mean great ancient Africa, the kingdom of Kush, the Kedah dynasty, Songhai and Timbuktu, Solomon and Sheba. No, African history and black history aren't necessarily the same. Black history is a separate branch of African history that extends beyond its borders. Black history is the American history that was omitted from your textbooks. Aesop, St. Augustine, and Pushkin were of African heritage. There are people of African descent throughout the world, from Indonesia to the Soviet Union. But those who have waged the most enduring struggle for their rights are blacks in the nation that was founded on civil liberties, freedom, and equality, the United States of America. The black quest in the United States has been the litmus paper on which the proclaimed ideals of the Declaration of Independence and the Constitution have been tested. The results indicate that liberty and justice for all has been more fancy than fact. The Explorers. Blacks were in the New World before Columbus arrived. They participated in the first explorations. Blacks were in Cortez's crew in Mexico, with Pizarro in Peru and Alvarado in Quito. When Balboa discovered the Pacific Ocean, 30 blacks were with him, including Nuflo de Olano. When Alarcon and Coronado conquered New Mexico, blacks were with them, too. The best known of the black conquistadors was Estabanico. He initiated the opening of New Mexico and Arizona for Spain. If there are misunderstandings between black and white people today, it's because misconceptions about blacks have been allowed to thrive. The only way to help abolish stereotypes is to present a more complete picture of black people in history. Native Americans in the Chicago area claimed that the first white man to settle at Chicago was a Negro. Jean-Baptiste Pont du Sable, a black man who came to the Mississippi Valley with French explorers, founded the city of Chicago by constructing the first building on the site that developed into the Windy City. It's inspiring to know that blacks made a triumphant entrance into the Western world, but considering the circumstances of millions of blacks today, something went wrong. Something called slavery. The First Challenge. The Afro-European slave trade began in 1441 when a Portuguese prince, Henry the Navigator, sought wealth from Africa and Asia. Henry sent a mariner, Antonio Gonçalves, to the west coast of Africa near Cape Bojador to investigate. Gonçalves brought gold dust and 10 Africans back to Lisbon for the prince as a display of Africa's wealth. The prince gave the Africans to the Pope. The Pope, in turn, granted Henry title to lands discovered east of Cape Blanco. Portugal dominated this area near Senegal, and with it, the African trade market, for nearly a century. A papal bull prevented Spain from going into Africa, but did give her the bulk of the New World. Spain contracted other nations to procure slaves for her. The contract was called an asiento, and was a symbol of power. By 1460, approximately 600 slaves were entering Portugal annually. In Lisbon, blacks outnumbered whites. The Portuguese didn't invent slavery. For example, the ancient Greeks kept slaves, and Moses led the Israelites out of bondage in Egypt. On the west coast of the Dark Continent, a slave system was initiated and perpetuated for economic purposes. The Commercial Revolution offered carte blanche to those who sought to exploit in order to rise on the social and economic ladder. There were three distinct stages on the journey from Africa to the New World. 1. Capture and conditioning in Africa. 2. The sea voyage or Middle Passage. 3. Seasoning in the West Indies. European traders rationalized that slavery was a holy cause because it introduced heathens to Christianity. The roots of the slave trade. The captured were members of various tribes. They were kidnapped or captured in tribal wars and sold. European traders established posts along the West African coastline, where beads, guns, whiskey, and ivory were bartered for bodies. Men and women could be purchased from independent African slaves too. Chiefs often appointed a cabossier, an African who gathered those who were to be sold. The slaves and the cabossier led the capture in the long march to the coastline. Those who were best fit physically were sought, the strong, brave, and healthy. After the long march, the captured chained two by two were taken to Negro houses or prison. The strongest were branded with the stamp of the trading company. Incarceration in the Negro house was followed by the chained march to the ship for the transatlantic voyage. The journey lasted from 8 to 10 weeks. Many of the captured attempted to escape by jumping overboard. Others refused to eat. A slave ship's crew member often broke the teeth of the hunger strikers and force-fed them. Loss of a black life meant loss of revenue. The captured shared no common language. Some went mad in the claustrophobic quarters. Others murdered those next to them in order to gain space. Ship captains estimated that they would lose a percentage of African cargo in death via escape, suffocation, or illness. There was even insurrection insurance. The seasoning period lasted from 3 to 4 years. Backs and spirits were broken in order to transform the Africans into American slaves. They were trained by other slaves or by whites who had experience in breaking in even the most rebellious arrivals. Each slave was given a work assignment, repeating a task for 12 hours each day. Any inclination towards suicide was beaten out of them. The death rate was high during the seasoning period because of the inability of slaves to adjust to the food or climate. Absentee landlordism was responsible for the excess of brutality towards the slaves. Plantation owners entrusted their lands to overseers who saw slaves as beasts of burden. In the 16th century, 887,500 slaves were imported. In the 17th, 2,750,000. In the 18th, 7 million, and in the 19th, 3,250,000. Slaves worked the sugar crop, which was shipped to New England, processed into rum, and then used to purchase more slaves in Africa. Europeans turned the Caribbean into a slave-making factory. By 1724, there were 32,000 blacks to 14,000 whites in Jamaica. The high percentage of blacks gave rise to the strict black codes. The white populace feared insurrection, knowing that in numbers they were at a disadvantage. The sooner a slave accepted his or her helplessness, the better for those who sought to exploit. In 1667, British Parliament adopted an act to regulate the Negroes on the British plantations. The Black Codes. Highlights of this act. 1. If a slave owner beats his slaves to death, or kills one by mistake, there shall be no legal repercussions. 2. All slaves must carry a pass at all times. 3. Slaves shall be whipped or branded on the face if they strike a Christian. 4. Christians are not held responsible for destroying personal property. Slaves. Black codes, slave codes, states' rights, Jim Crow laws, segregation, racial discrimination, home rule. What do these words really mean? Fear and greed, which created the first codes, remained and existed throughout time. 1667. The fear. High percentage of imported blacks and possible revolts. The solution? Black codes. 1822-1831. The fear. Slaves like Vesey and Nat Turner rebel and kill whites. The solution? Slave codes. 1865. The fear. Post-Civil War slaveholders in South want to remain master. The solution. Home rule. 1886. The fear. Rutherford B. Hayes needs Southern votes to win election. The solution. States' rights. 1896. The fear. Homer Plessy challenges legality of separate but equal railroad cars. The solution. Jim Crow laws. 1890s. The fear. Blacks try to better their lives using the ballot, education, organization, and protest. The solution. Segregation and discrimination. The plantation owners and overseers had reason to fear the slaves rising against them, because slaves fought back whenever possible. In 1522, there was a rebellion on the island of Santo Domingo, and in 1526, the slaves in a settlement, which was to become South Carolina, revolted from the 500 Spaniards who held them. Some of the blacks escaped to Haiti. Others took refuge with Native Americans. Uprisings continued sporadically until the slaves were freed in the 19th century. The outstanding resistors of the Black Coast.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.